Hello, everybody, and welcome.
Nothing Much vlog. I'm here with Greg today. We're crossing the street, so we gotta be cautious to look both ways. We just came out of Jackson Square Mall. We're on our morning walk. Heading into Gore Park in downtown Hamilton. There's the bus. It's not too bad of a day out. A little overcast, but it's not raining, so I'm happy with that. We're just waiting to cross the street here. Walk into Gore Park, which you can see behind me. And it says to walk, so we shall walk.
Obey. Follow the sign.
Obey the traffic laws. Now, I think this hat, like, pushes down my ears. Does it look weird?
No.
So it, like, pushes down and sticks my ears out. And
it probably also because your sunglasses.
Yeah, the sunglasses kind of do that, too.
I know if I put my hat all the way, my ears go.
Yeah, it, like, sticks my ears out, and I look like an elf. Anyways, I thought today, Greg and I would discuss our favorite music with you. What music we like to listen to. Before I begin, I like to say comment in the comment section below and tell me what music you like to listen to. And what do you think about the stuff we like to listen to? Let me know what you think of it. So, Greg, what do you listen to? What kind of music do you like? Before you start, look at this beautiful fountain. Very pretty. It's going to be pretty loud, so we'll walk away. So, Greg, now, what kind of music do you like to listen to?
Well, I mean, I can go all the way back to my beginnings of listening to music, and I would listen. I have an older brother, and I pretty much would listen to whatever he was listening to, because I didn't really have my own taste in music. And I actually was talking about this earlier today. I had found some Beatles CDs at my dad's house, and so I listened to those, and I was totally getting into that. So I was down in the States on vacation, and I went to a Kmart, which for the Canadians, we don't have Kmart anymore. So
stepped on a grate.
And so I went to the Kmart, and they had only one Beatles CD, and it was Magical Mystery Tour. So I bought it, I took it home, popped it into my Discman at the time, which I guess is dating me.
I used to have a Discman. I used to be pro at like cradling it when I walked to work, so I didn't skip.
It's all about the anti-skip too.
Yeah.
So anyway, listen to that. A couple of the first songs, okay. And then it got to a song called Your Mother Should Know, and it's on, like I said, Magical Mystery Tour. And it pretty much made me realize, like, I'm going to like this band for the rest of my life. So, I mean, long-winded answer is the Beatles are my favorite band. But then I've then gone from there. I don't think that person's supposed to drive.
That's not a place you're supposed to drive. It's
so,
like a walkway.
I mean, from the Beatles, I have expanded my who I like. I generally like classic rock.
The building's missing.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Got torn down. It's a big hole in that building up there. Is that the Connaught?
I think so, yeah.
Oh, they're gonna put some condos in there.
Yeah, I think the condos potentially.
Whoa, look at this. Sorry to interrupt you, Greg. This is just interesting. Cool. It's a big hole in the buildings. Interesting. Sorry to interrupt you. I just thought that was cool.
That's more exciting than what I'm talking about.
I like hearing.
So, I generally listen to classic rock. I also like some things that are acoustic, you know, folky. Another guy who's, you know, if you take a step away from the Beatles and anybody that in the Beatles, in the last probably 5 years or so, really. One of my favorite artists is a guy named Joel Plaskett, and he's from
I love Joel Plaskett too.
He's from Canada.
Nova Scotia, isn't he?
Yeah.
Halifax, Nova Scotia is the land of the free.
Yeah. So, I mean, the first album that I heard from him was called Free. And it was a 3-disc album, and it had a very interesting theme throughout the album. A lot of the song titles had a word repeated,
or
three times. Rewind, rewind.
Precious.
Et cetera, et cetera, et
cetera. Rolling.
So I listened to that and I was hooked to him. So then after that point, I was like, I have to consume anything he's done. And I've followed him since, and I've seen him a couple times live, and
he's great.
He is really good to watch live. He is really down to earth.
He's pretty inclusive with the audience.
Yeah, he does a lot of smaller venues, so you can talk to him, you can keep, you know, there's a good close connection when he's actually performing. So that's who, I mean, for this short period of time, for this segment, I'll leave it at that. But what about you, Mike?
Well, I must say, I like Joel Plaskett. Greg and my other friend, Brolin, they both got me into Joel Plaskett. I never really listened, like, I've listened to the Beatles, but I've never really gotten into them. I'm trying to think of my musical history here. Of like, first of all, the first CD I ever had was Space Jam, the Space Jam's soundtrack. I don't know. My parents liked a lot of good music, so I usually got into whatever they're listening to.
I think my parents might be a little bit older than your parents, so your parents' music might have been slightly different than
they both. Liked like Billy Idol and Teenage Head, the Cars.
Yeah, that's definitely my parents were. I mean, my mom and I, even she's rubbed off on me. I love Motown music.
Oh, nice.
And that's because she grew up and she won a radio as a kid from a contest, and this is back quite a while ago. Not to date my mom. But
you don't want to date your mom.
I also don't want to date my mom. I love her, but not that kind of way. Anyway, so she had won that's a big puddle.
Look at the size of that puddle. Oh, I thought the car was going to drive through, but he's not.
So she had won a radio from this radio station, and I guess it could get like only like two or three radio stations, and one of them was a station from Detroit, which was at the time was playing Motown music. So she like grew up listening to that, and then, you know, I grew up also hearing it and respecting it. So Motown is also good. So, sorry, continue on.
Oh, I'm just trying to think. Like, back in high school, I used to listen to Sloan. They're a big...
Yeah, I followed them a lot when I was in college.
I grew up listening... Like, I'd always get the Big Shiny Tunes CDs from Much Music every year. And kind of, I like Sloan off of that. I used to watch music videos on Much Music all the time. So growing up, I really like kind of like rock music. I like Sloan. I'm trying to think of other bands. I was into Green Day a bit. I also really like, and I still kind of do, like Nickelback. Some people
I dislike
may
them.
Not have the
I'm
same
thing. I'm going to put it out there, not to sugarcoat, I actually hate them.
I don't like, I've seen them twice, and they're both in really fun shows, so I'm not a hater on Nickelback. I enjoy their music from time to time, but anyways, getting into like, I liked a lot of punk music too. Started off like the Ramones, obviously, the Clash. When I was growing up, I got introduced to Real Big Fish, and that kind of like turned my whole genre of music into the whole punk ska thing. So I really like Real Big Fish. I listen to all their albums. I've seen them, I think, five or six times live, so I'm a big fan of them. Also, through Real Big Fish, I learned about Suburban Legends. They're another ska band from the Anaheim area. They play in Disneyland too, but I really like their music and I've really gotten into them. And like, I always used to be a Green Day fan, like I casually listened to them, but I think once American Idiot came out, I started listening to them more and more.
Do you know when that one came out?
2004.
Okay.
So about then, like I had Nimrod, and I've listened to that, and Dookie as well.
I think part of me is a bit jaded against Green Day in the sense that I think I heard one or two of their songs and they would use them for every little thing.
That's the thing, like I'm really big into Green Day. They are my favorite band. Like, I just grew like them more and more and more until that's like they are number one, and I love their music. So Green Day is definitely my favorite band. Real Big Fish would be my second favorite band. But I agree, like I tend to not like the singles as much. Like, I used to I did not like Good Riddance, Time of Your Life. Only because, like, every year at graduation
that,
at school, they're like...
That was probably quite a lot.
But now it's one of the songs I love because it's kind of... I don't hear it all the time. I listen to it less. And every time I hear it now, I'm like, oh, this is a really good song. It's not...
And that's the beauty of music is it'll play to different parts of your where you are in your life or whatever. So, you know, you can hear it a million times and you say, I never want to hear the song again. And then, you know, 5 years go by and then you go, you could be in a totally different place in your life and say, this song means something completely different now than it did 5 years ago, which is the best thing about music is it's, you know, subjective to whoever's listening to it.
Very true. I'm trying to think whether, like, there are other songs like Boulevard of Broken Dreams and all those singles. Like, I like them, but not as much as some of their other songs. They have a lot of really good songs. I could just list, like, a shitload, but I'm not going to. We don't have time for that. I'm trying to think of other bands I really like. I like another band that's kind of cool. I kind of learned through Real Big Fish was Zoloft, the Rock and Roll Destroyer. They're a cool band. I like Less Than Jake. Social Distortion, Barenaked Ladies. I love the Barenaked Ladies. I've seen them 4 or 5 times. I'm going to go see them again in November. You like the Barenaked Ladies, don't you, Greg?
Yeah. I don't know enough of their songs to say I'm a fan. What I have heard, I enjoy.
I'm quite the fan of the Barenaked Ladies. I'm trying to think.
BNL?
BNL. I remember that was on Community. Yeah, like, why did they have to shorten that? I'm trying to think of some other bands.
What was your favorite all-time concert? Big, small?
I've seen a few that, like I said, I've seen Green Day. I'm trying to think which one. And Barenaked Ladies. I think those would be my top two. There's, I think, Green Day at the Molson Amphitheater. They played 3 hours. It was an awesome show, and it was long. But, like, every song, I was like, yeah! And they just kept playing and playing. It was outside. It was a beautiful night. And so that was a really good show, and I really enjoyed it. there's a poll! Another concert I also really liked was, like I said, Barenaked Ladies. They played at Massey Hall. It was like one of their Christmas shows. They played a few Christmas songs, but it was mostly just like their regular set. But it was one of the last shows they played with Stephen Page, which was kind of sad because just... Okay.
And he had some hard times.
Yeah, well, like it was, I remember they played a second encore. They ended the show, and then they had an encore If I Had $1 Million, and then they played a second encore of What a Good Boy, which is another one of my favorite songs.
What was the story? I didn't hear that.
What a Good Boy.
Oh, okay.
It's from
Gordon. I don't know if I've heard that.
It's on their Gordon album. Anyway, it's a really good song. Just listen to it when you get back. They played that, and it was just like, it was like one of those perfect songs of like a perfect night, and you're just like, wow. It's a wicked venue. Massey Hall is a beautiful venue. And it was great. This makes me sad because like that moment was so cool.
They're just looking at, sorry, that's directed by the guy in the background. Dude, he's covered with a blanket.
What?
I think they thought he was dead or something.
I don't know.
He's not dead.
He's not dead.
I saw him move his hands.
All right.
I totally stopped listening. I was distracted by that guy.
No, I'm just saying this song, this moment, it's like, oh, this is perfect. And it's sad because like that lineup, it's no more. Stephen Page isn't in the band anymore.
Do you think they'll ever be able to reconcile? Or?
I think they're willing to let him back. Like, I think it was completely his choice to leave. That's why their one song, Runaway, is about that.
Now, since he's left, does it have the same feeling? Or does it just kind of feel like a different band now?
It's definitely a different band. Well, like, it's feel like the band's been cut in half. Because majority of the songs, well, they kind of split them. But I think majority were written by and sung by... Stephen Page, probably about 51%, I would say.
I'd imagine if it was, say, like, if you had John Lennon leave the Beatles, but the Beatles stay together.
Yeah.
Most of the songs are sung by one or the other, John or Paul, so I can imagine that would be like, you lose part of what made the band the band.
Yeah. I think those are my two favorite concerts. I think Green Day at the Molson Amphitheater. Barenaked Ladies at Massey Hall. That I can remember.
Yeah.
I mean, I've been to quite a few, so. What about you? Your favorite concert?
Well, I've seen Joe Plaskett a couple times. I've seen Sloan a bunch of times. I actually saw, well, I think my ultimate would have been, I've seen Paul McCartney 3 times.
Oh, that's cool.
I saw him twice in Toronto and once in Cleveland. And, I think it was the one time I saw him in Toronto. I had floor seats, probably 12th row or so. So at the time I was probably, I forget how old I was, but I was I had brought a t-shirt that said "You Are Here," and I was holding that up throughout the show, and I don't know why. And then at every concert that Paul McCartney does, he sings "Hey Jude," and it's a long song on its own, but what he also does is he breaks it down and he pretty much just makes it a sing-along, which is great for the audience.
Yeah, that's cool.
And at one point, you know, he says, you know, just the guy sing, just the girl sing, just the upper bowl, just the floor, whatever. And at one point, and I have an audio recording of this, but he sees that I'm holding up the shirt. So he points at me and he says, "It's true. And you are here too." And then he starts singing back into "Hey Jude."
Nah, that's cool.
And me and my buddy at the time, we were just like,
so pumped.
We were so free. We were freaking out. We were just like, we couldn't believe that. I mean, for someone like Paul McCartney, obviously that would be such an insignificant
gesture
thing, just in the moment. But for me, I'll remember that forever.
It's locked in.
So.
Yeah, that's really
I think
cool.
That made it my ultimate favorite. I mean, it was a great concert regardless, because he puts on, you know, 3 hours. The only thing he does before is he has a DJ that mixes some of his own work, like his own, like Paul McCartney stuff. He'll mix it before the show starts. And then Paul McCartney goes on for 3 hours and does a couple encores, and it's a great night. So.
Well, that sounds...
But it's, I mean, seeing Joel Plaskett a couple times in very small, intimate venues has also been very nice, because, you know, you could say, "Hey, play this song." "Oh, okay." But he wouldn't normally have played, but you request it and he'll play it. Or you go and talk to him after the show and you'll just be like, "Hey, thanks for playing that song for me," or whatever. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of like you get one huge show with one of the biggest musicians ever, or a guy who is underrated in a very small venue, and you know,
I like that too. I've seen Jay Malinowski from Bedouin Soundclash. I like Bedouin Soundclash, and I've seen them live, and I've also seen Jay play live by himself at a smaller venue at the Casbah here in Hamilton, and it was really cool. Same thing after the show, I was like standing right there, and I just went right up to him, like, "Hey, man, that's a cool show." He's like, "Thanks." He had a little talk. He signed my CD, and it was just cool like that.
That's one thing. I mean, you mentioned the Casbah. I've been there a couple times, and I love being able to go, either not knowing anybody who's going to be performing and walking out going to see one specific person, but then walking out finding out, holy smokes, I just found a new favorite artist that I've never even heard of that they were opening or playing before the person.
And, the tree, sorry, I was ducking.
And you discover people that way that you would never suspect or even imagine that you could ever learn to like.
It's funny you say that. There's this one guy I watch online, Justin Scard. You probably know him if you know Disneyland videos. He has Random Land videos, and he's got a band, and he had some stuff on his YouTube and stuff, and I looked into that, and I'm really into that stuff right now. So it's funny how you can just like find little bits of music everywhere you go, and some of it's really good, and which this is, and I'm really enjoying it.
I mean, I get very random with my music sometimes, so I'll go and moments where I'll just go, I want to listen to 50s rock and roll, so I'll listen to that for a couple weeks, and I'll have that, and then you know, oh, now I'm going to listen to Motown for a bit, or then even classical, and just
the cycle. It just, some things get thrown in it, and then like as you go, some things get thrown out, and it just keeps going. And like the best is like when something's out of the cycle, and you're just like going through your library, and it's like a song comes on. Well, nowadays we have computers, it just like pops up when you're on shuffle, and you're just like, "Oh my god, I forgot about this song," and then you listen to it for a couple of weeks, and then it kind of slowly goes out of the cycle and just keeps happening over and over again, and just whatever kind of mood you're in, whatever you're feeling. So yeah, that's the beauty of the music today. I remember when like CDs, like the thing, you just listen to the CD straight through, and then like when MP3s came out, I'm like, I could never do that. Like I'm always like about like the album and listening straight through, but now I'm like, no.
Well, it's weird you say that. Like, you look so used to a CD, I wouldn't even listen to on shuffle very often. But you get to like, I'll use the Beatles as an example. I could hear a song, and as the song is wrapping up, my head is already going to the next song. But if I hear that now on like on a shuffle or whatever, my head's going to the next song, but then it cuts to something else, and you're almost thrown off. It's like, man, I need to go back and listen to these things in order as they were kind of meant to be listened to.
You ever have that thing happen when you're on shuffle, and you're like, you know what, I never heard this song in a while, I wonder if it's going to, and it comes on next, you're like, no way.
Undeniably a freak out.
You're like,
all the time.
It's like I have ESPN. Anyways, we've gone on long enough.
Hopefully you've stuck around.
Yeah, if you stuck around, hashtag, I've stuck around. Hashtag stuck around.
Yeah. And at least I'm going to suggest, if you haven't, go check out Joel Plaskett. I'm not trying to, like, help him out or anything. I'm just saying, just do yourself a favor. And
it's got good some stuff.
Listen to his album called Free. And
I like his new album, too. Park Avenue Park Sobriety Avenue. Test.
It's a great name to an album and a song, but definitely give him a shot. Like, if you like kind of acoustic, folky, rock and roll.
He's got such a wide variety, too. Like,
he can play almost anything, it seems.
Like, rock songs, and then, like, the one show we went to was, like, all acoustic, and then he's a good musician. Check him out.
Go check him out. Maybe he'll... Maybe Mike will put Joel's information.
I'll put a link to Sweet Songs. A song that I like and a song that Greg likes. I'll put it down below, and you can check it out. Also, like I said at the beginning, tell me what kind of music you like to listen to, what you think of the music me and Greg listen to. Try not to hate on Nickelback too much. I know people hate them. I know, like, some of their songs are kind of like that, but I just, once in a while, I like to listen to Nickelback. Anyways, thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. Check out Greg's channel, too. He's starting up a... going to put videos up more often. We just did a one where we had a race, and my legs are still burning from the other day. I was trying to catch Greg. We were racing, and we were all holding selfies like this, and I was pretty close, so I was like, I might be able to catch him, and I gave like 110%, and I didn't catch him, and I really should have stretched. My legs still hurt, so I'm out of shape. So anyways, check that out.
See you later.
See you later. Have a good one. Like and subscribe. Bye-bye.